El camino al Maidao and his pipes. Nice to be here once more with you all again. Usually always address the crowd first, address the gathering based on the subject. Then I go for question and answer. Today I thought we will have a small change. Let you start with questions. I'll come to the subject. From the questions, I'll come to the subject. Subject is supposed to be science to spirituality. Can start with any question. I'll answer your questions, then come to the subject. That first I'll spend few minutes with you all, casually, informally, then I'll come to the subject. Somebody wants the mic.
Namaste Swamiji. Just before you arrived, the gentleman who was introducing you raised a very important concept which is pretty new to me. What is cosmic intelligence?
The knowledge about all the past, whatever has happened and present, what is happening, and the future, whatever is going to happen, is what we call cosmic intelligence. See, just 20 years ago, if somebody says, 20 years ago if somebody would have made a statement like this, that you can get all the information, whatever information you want, just by clicking a button in your laptop or in your computer, in your home PC, you would have believed. 20 years ago, if somebody makes a statement, oh, just by pressing a button, you will get all informations in your laptop, in your home PC, in your computer, surely you wouldn't have believed in it. Surely you would have said, he is fantasizing, or he is imagining. But today, it has become reality. You can get any information just because of internet. Anything you can get just by one click. Just all you need is one click, you will get any information in the home PC or in your laptop. Same way, when I make a statement, with the right technique, it is possible for you also to download any information, anything available in the cosmos. When I make this statement, again you are in difficulty. 20 years ago, if somebody makes a statement, you can get anything you want in your laptop just by a click. Surely you will not, you wouldn't have believed. You would have questioned, you would have criticized. Same way, when I make statement, we are not ready to understand. It is possible. Just how we can download information because of internet, from internet. Same way, you can download anything available in the cosmos. Anything available, all you need to know is a simple technique or little bit of intelligence to handle the browsing center which is in you. I call this browse center, Ajna, as a browsing center. If you know how to activate the third eye or the browse center of your being, of your consciousness, simply you can download any information about the past or about the present or about the future. When I say cosmic intelligence, I don't propose a theory. I say it is an authentic reality which is experienced by thousands of mystics, spiritual masters enlightened beings, again and again, they emphasize the cosmic intelligence is possible. We are again and again opposing that it is not possible. The only small difficulty is, all we need to do is have a little courage and work towards it. Have a little courage, you see. You will get any information, but you have to click. You have to click. At least you should type the computer. You should handle it. You should connect it. Only then it is possible. There's a small story. One guy, he was telling me, one of his friends, he's too lazy. He says to one of his friends, if there is a machine, just by switching it on, it does all our job. It should cook, it should drive, it should do our job, it should massage our feet. If it does everything, how nice it will be. The other guy, friend, said, if the machine also automatically gets switched on, how nice it will be. We need at least a little bit of courage to work towards it. So I tell you, anybody who has got a little bit of courage to work towards it, to achieve it, will be able to realize the truth behind my word. We think it is too good to be true. The idea of cosmic intelligence, the theory of cosmic intelligence, looks like too good to be true, but it is not. It is real and authentic science. Just like you use the internet and browse, download the informations, same way, if you know a little bit how to handle your consciousness, you can download any information from cosmos about the past or the present or the future. The science is what I call meditation and understanding about your energies. Usually, we don't respect ourselves. We don't believe that we can also do something solid. That is the difficulty. Again and again, even when you come and sit here, you listen and you feel very good about the whole thing. Oh, Swami spoke nicely. I have always seen the end of the discourse, people will come near me and tell, Swami, you spoke wonderfully. I just used to catch them. What did I speak? Tell me. What did I say? Tell me. Oh, that. You said nicely, Swamiji. You said nicely. Whatever you spoke is nicely. I can't remember, but you spoke nicely. Only this is the depth with which we are listening the whole thing. We don't take things sincerely. We just take all these things as a one more time pass. If you have come here as a one more time pass, enjoy, it's okay, forget about it. Or if you are really sincere about what I am speaking, have a little courage to come with me. Try to explore. Try to work. Have a little bit of courage to find or to go to the depth of what I am speaking, what I am expressing. Thank you. Next.
Since the topic is science to spirituality, I've been thinking about where the vibration of the strings is turning into particles, which vibrates at different frequencies. The thought process that you develop, right, which you are not under control, but your thought is an energy, it's a vibration, it's a fundamental vibration of some kind. And have you done any research in this area?
Nice. Beautiful question. You made a statement. Thought is not under our control. That is the only mistake you did. Everything else is right. Whatever you said is right. Wonderful thing. But only one alteration. The thought is under our control. Please understand. Who else can think for you? analyze, if the thought process is not under your control, who is thinking sitting inside you? Nobody else can think sitting inside you. It is you who is thinking. Only thing, the frequency of the thought has become too much associated with the materials. The frequency of the thoughts has become too much than the frequency of consciousness or awareness. There are two things, frequency of awareness and frequency of thoughts. What exactly Sri theory says is what is proved by the Vedanta, what we call the ancient science of inner world. Now let me come to the subject, the science to spirituality. When you are really scientific, you will become spiritual. When you are scientifically scientific, you will be spiritual. Understand this simple one thing. There are two things, unscientifically scientific and scientifically scientific. Anybody who explores science needs few basic qualifications. The first qualification is courage to listen new things. Courage to listen new things. Courage to hear or look into new hypotheses. First thing is courage to look into new things. Second, ready to work with that new things with an open mind. Ready to work with that new things with an open mind, without prejudiced or contaminated by your old thought process or the knowledge which is available to you. Third thing, the power or the courage to go behind the truth which is discovered. Please understand, you need three things to be a real scientist. To be scientifically a scientist, logically logic. To be really a scientist, you need these three things. First, the courage to hear new ideas, openness. Second, the courage to analyze them without your prejudices. See, we have two things called listening the arguments and passing the judgment. Another one is preparing the judgment and then collecting arguments to support the judgment. Most of the time, in our life, the judgment is ready. We just collect or search for arguments which will support our judgment. Second thing which you need to do, the basic thing is understanding or trying to work with the ideas without any prejudice or with a corrupted mind, with your old knowledge. The third thing, very important thing, the courage to follow the truth which is discovered by you. Actually, there is a wonderful book on the knowledge of inner world. According to me, the religion of the outer world is science, and the science of the inner world is spirituality. Two different worlds. The logic of the outer world is science. The logic of the inner world is spirituality. There is I can say this is the ultimate book ever written on the spirituality. This book is called Brahma Sutra, means aphorisms on existence. Aphorisms on existence. According to me, this is the unabridged dictionary of world philosophies. unabridged dictionary of world philosophies. This book starts with a beautiful statement. Atato Brahma Jignasat means, now let us inquire into the truth of the Brahman. A clear scientific mind is represented by this one sloka, by this one aphorism. How a scientific mind should work is very clearly explained. Atato Brahma Jignasat means, now let us inquire into the truth of existence. This statement very clearly proves, first, you will have the courage to inquire into the truth, or new ideas, new dimensions. Next, you will have open mind to work with the ideas, to process them, to analyze them, to categorize them, to understand them. Third thing, you will have the courage to work them out in your life, to put them into practice in your life, or to make them as a reality in your life. When these three things are there, only then you can be called a scientist. You can be called as a person who is working with science. In any field you want a new opening or a breakthrough, only a man who has got these three qualities can do it. Whether it is information technology or the physics or the chemistry or whatever it may be the field, these three qualities are basic need for any breakthrough, any new discovery, or any new research, or anything new has to happen. It can happen only through these three qualities. If you have really courage and have these three qualities, you will simply be a spiritual man. Because spirituality needs these three basic things. You need to explore the new dimensions of your being. You need to have courage to analyze the new truths or the new ideas which is coming to your being. Third thing, you need to have the courage to follow the satya which you discover. Follow the truth which you discover. The conscious transformation